Okay, fellas, hey, this is Art for Superfit again. As I told you, we discovered this, a few tutorials on the black roll itself online, but you can literally find no tutorials on the dual balls, which is like their newest product. So we figured out we just hit that product firstly. Just to repeat, we have a big dual ball, which is about 12 centimeters in diameter, and we've got the smaller one, which is 8 centimeters in diameter. Right? The difference is just the size. Surprise, surprise. The bigger one is not as accurate as the small one. So with the black roll, you will hit large muscle groups. You can work on the large ones. And with the balls, you're actually able to work pretty accurate on one spot, on one trigger point. So naturally, the bigger one will not be as accurate and precise for this kind of work as the small ones. You could actually say like the bigger ones are more for beginners and the smaller ones are more for like professionals, advanced athletes kind of. Because they will hurt more as they get deeper into the tissue and they will be more effective, in my kind of view, than the bigger ones. But the bigger ones are more effective to get bigger range of motion. So you will see in the first exercise I show you, which is the T-spine smash, right? So you just start the exercise by lining the double, or the dual, I'm sorry, just around the beginning of your rib cage, okay? From here, you start giving yourself a big hug, because with this big hug, you will get all the soft tissue and your scapula out of the way, so you can actually deal with the moving segments of your back, all right? So from here, you just overextend until your head touches the floor and stay in that position until you actually feel a change in your tissue. Okay, if you do feel a change in that tissue, you come back up in a crunch motion, right? Like ab workout motion, and you will move your ass a little closer to your feet. To move up one vertebra on the ball, okay? And then you just can repeat the movement, overextend, and stay here until you feel a change in your tissue. And then perform another crunch, and move a little closer again, okay? If you do not want to stay in that kind of overextended position, because of blood flow into your head, because you're sissy, I don't know. There's another variation of this exercise where you will start at the rib cage again. Alright, I hope you can see that. Give yourself a big hug, as I said, to get soft tissue and cap the scapula out of the way. And then just perform five crunches to 3, 4, and 5, and then you will get your ass up, moving a little closer to your feet, and move up one vertebra with the ball until you actually hit your neck. Okay? So you just overextend from here and do that crunch motion again. Right. You can also when you're overextended, you can also move up with your hip and then move back down. Okay, so just keep it varied. There's no wrong way, as Kelly Starrett always says in these kind of exercises. With self-myofascial release, there's really no wrong way. You just need to do it. Okay, and yeah, just to show you the smaller balls as well, there's one more exercise I want to show you with that. You start the same way, just around the beginning of your rib cage. Lie down. Give yourself a big hug again. And now it's T-spine smash rotation. So you actually just get your weight on one side. Stay here until you do feel a change or start to shiver, like I do. Go back to the middle and then rotate to the other side. Remember to breathe during this kind of work, alright? Because you really want to ease.
Okay.
So you don't want the muscles to be really, really tight. You want them to be actually pretty soft so the ball can get deep into the tissue and work its way through it. Okay. What I forgot to mention so far is what's so special about the double ball is its connection of the two balls, which is wide enough to actually protect your spine during the work. Right? So what you can do with the double ball is something you cannot do with a single ball. You can actually work your whole erector spinae by just lying down, giving yourself a hug, and just roll over it, okay? So you just roll all the way, and roll right here. That's pretty good, and you will never ever hit the spine, which is absolutely awesome for the kind of ab movements we did just before, right? So the T-spine smash. Right, I hope you can fix some of your T-spine problems with that. And just if you have any questions, just give me a call or write me an email.